The 20s were roaring and Babe was a hero, and Lindy reached Paris somehow. The war was long over and surely the world was safe for democracy now. They banged on the drums and they tooted the fifes and said they were mighty and great. But all of their rhetoric couldn't protect from a soul being tortured by hate. It happened in Beth, in the middle of Michigan. A bright sunny day as the summer was dawning. It happened in Beth, in the time of our innocence, safe in the heartland where nightmares came only in dreams. He wasn't an alien or stranger in town. His face was familiar to all. He spoke the same language and dreamed the same dreams, but his fortunes had taken a fall. He blamed the townspeople and silently vowed the awful revenge of a ghoul. By trying to kill a whole generation with dynamite under the school. It happened in Beth, in the middle of Michigan. A bright sunny day as the summer was dawning. It happened in Beth, in the time of our innocence, safe in the heartland where nightmares came only in dreams. While many were killed in the horrible blast, a miracle happened that day. For much of the dynamite didn't ignite, and most of the kids got away. While they were still counting their blessings, the man drove back toward the horror he'd shaped and blew up his vehicle. More people died, including one child who'd escaped. It happened in Beth, in the middle of Michigan. A bright sunny day as the summer was dawning. It happened in Beth, in the time of our innocence, safe in the heartland where nightmares came only in dreams. 45 lives had been ended that day. 38 children were lost. Many survivors kept living their lives and watching their children at play. They tucked them in bed with a comforting word, no worries that they couldn't cure. The children had nights full of safety and peace. How else could the parents endure? It happened in Beth, in the middle of Michigan. A bright sunny